So, Jim, it's the time of the show where we look ahead at this upcoming series, which we've kind of previewed already. They're playing the Cubs again. Just, I guess, a little bit slightly different pitching, which mm-hmm. that didn't matter at all, clearly. Mister, what if they sweep the Cubs? Yeah, that didn't matter. But they play the Cubs again. And I don't know. I don't know how to talk about this one because it was the disaster last time. And then they, you know, they took only one out of three, the Guardians, and now the Cubs are back. And I got to say, too, like the Cubs are just, they are hot. They are playing some good baseball. That offense is just on fire.
Yeah,
does it bode well for the Pirates and Derek Shelton's future?
I was going to say, like, I feel like I just looked and the Cubs were, you know, scuffling in a game or two under 500. And now you look and they're 71-66. They're five games over 500. They're still nine games back of the Brewers. So that likely isn't happening. But the Cubs are like, they're at least still in contention for a wild card spot, which is wild because, you know, at the deadline, you did not think that was the case, but they're just three games behind the Braves right now for that last wild card spot. Only the Mets are ahead of them when it comes to battling for that position. Yeah, they're on fire. They've won six in a row. They're 9-1 in their last 10. They've got their you know, Shota Imanaga's back healthy. So they've kind of got their full pitching staff going. Yeah, they're playing really well offensively. Like you mentioned, Seiya Suzuki on fire. Nico Horner on fire. Dansby Swanson's on fire. Pete Crow Armstrong has come up and has played really, really well. Bellinger, Parisi since coming. Like, this team, they can hit. This team can hit up and down the lineup. There's not really a guy. Like, Michael Busch is your worst hitter at this point as far as guys who have, you know, like recently. But Busch has put together a pretty solid rookie season himself. Yeah, this is a good team. They've like turned themselves into a good team. And you mentioned like for the future, like the Cubs are the team that you got to worry the most about in this division because they're the one team that can just spend whatever they want at any point in time. And they haven't chosen to do that really lately. They did spend a bit this offseason. But they're like the one really big market team that you got to deal with in the NL Central. Everyone else you're kind of on a level playing field with. St. Louis is, you know, probably a step above, you know, Milwaukee, Cincinnati, Pittsburgh. But like Chicago's the team where if they want to go out there and just outspend everybody and just like beat teams because of money, they can do it. And so when you start combining money with good decisions and homegrown talent, they can start getting scary
for sure,
and things kind of seem to be clicking right now for them.
Well, and like oddly enough, right, we talked about their trade deadline just a little bit, but you know, it's kind of weird because the Cubs, like, what are you doing? You're not going anywhere. Why are you making these moves? Which some of the moves, and again, like we jokingly tell, those are like the moves you want to see the Pirates do like a year or two ago, right? Out of the deadline now for the future, but it's kind of working in their favor right now. And again, I don't know if, you know, playoffs are in their future or not, but they are a much better team. They are playing much better. And I definitely want to talk again, like last week we talked about how the pitching's strong, like for them, like starting pitching. That's why the matchups are really, really good outside of Hendricks. Their pitching rotation is pretty solid. Mm-hmm. But I mean, since August 1st, Jim, since August 1st, basically since the trade deadline, second best offense in baseball. Weighted runs created plus 123. The Cubs have a 123 weighted runs created plus, only behind the Diamondbacks, who are also just out of their mind, playing out of their mind. The Diamondbacks have a 135 collectively as a team weighted runs created plus. But the Cubs are second with a 123, better than the Yankees, better than the Padres, right? They have 37 home runs. They have 169 runs in total. To compare, the Pirates have 121 runs, 26 homers, and their weighted runs created plus is a 93. And like we've talked about the Pirates offense, it's like, you know what? It hasn't really been like the problem per se. You still need it to be better, but it hasn't like been the problem or was the problem earlier. And the Cubs are just destroying that. They are just lighting it up.
They're a
good ass team right now.
They're playing well, and it's top to bottom. And you've got Ian Happ, who just kills us every time we play him. Yeah, and like I said, Suzuki, Horner, Swanson, Pete Armstrong is playing really well right now too. And you saw what I mean. Pete Armstrong destroyed this team last week.
You saw firsthand.
Yeah, like he was doing whatever he wanted. I think he had. I don't know how many hits he had that series. 10. I mean, it felt like he was on base every single time. And then when he got on base, he stole second and then he stole third. Like that's what he did last week against the Pirates. So yeah, they got to deal with him again. You don't love it the way that this team's playing. I mean, you do look at the pitching matchups and you've got, you know, your first two starts, Taillon versus Jones tonight, and then Justin Steele, Paul Skenes. Tomorrow is what I've got showing. I don't think the Pirates have announced a starter for Wednesday yet, but Fangraphs is projecting that it's Domingo Herman. God, I hope not. But the Cubs are going Taillon, Steele, Imanaga.
That's a 1-2-3.
Those are three good pitchers. So, but the, I mean, Jones, Skenes, and then somebody else is two good pitchers. You know.
Yeah, we'll see. Not taking away from the pitching side on the Pirates, right? But like that's you know, like last week we talked. I mean, the pitching is strong, but the offense is also there. I mean, that Skenes start could very well be, you know, a 0-0 score at some point, and then you got to trust in the bullpen. And do you trust in the bullpen? No, not really. And again, like with this Cubs offense. So this kind of is a perfect wrap up to the show, which how it is, and talk about the Pirates season. Like here we are now in the first week of September, talked about a Cubs series, and it's this Cubs team looks good and scary.
Yeah, I think
foreshadowing the future of this division.
Yeah, I think we take one. I think we take at least one here.
You don't think the Cubs will sweep? I want to hear that.
I don't think the Cubs are going to sweep.
You can clip that up, Jim.
You can clip that up after the Pirates sweep. You can go ahead and clip that up, me saying I don't think the Cubs are going to sweep, and then you can make me look all silly and wrong and stuff. But yeah, I don't think that's going to happen. I think they win one, could win two. You never know. But yeah, I think Paul Skenes comes out there and shoves. Paul Skenes likes pitching in Wrigley.
He does.
I don't think he's giving up a hit in Wrigley.
So I want to say this, though. That game, Cal Nicklaus, your ass is on the bench. Because Cal Nicklaus does not like facing the Cubs. So let's not ruin that Paul Skenes start. So Paul Skenes come out and shove. Yeah. Cal Nicklaus, you sit still. You just stay there, kid. And we'll have some possible luck.
Let's just do complete game shutout, no hitter for Paul Skenes. On Tuesday.
Perfect.
Just don't.
Perfect.
We don't need the bullpen. It's been a while since it was July 23rd. Skenes went into the ninth inning against St. Louis. So, and it does seem like they're kind of easing up on the innings with him. So it's probably just going to be another 5 or 6 inning outing. But,
if he's super efficient,
if he's super efficient,
he's got, you know, 60 into the eighth.
Yeah.
Just throw a Greg Maddux. That's all.
Not asking for much here.
No. If Ivan Nova can do it, Paul, come on.
If Domingo Herman can pitch a perfect game, then anybody can. Honestly, right. Though, like I'm pretty sure that just shows you how much of a crapshoot. Like just a year ago, we were talking about a Domingo Herman perfect game. That's how weird baseball is.